I get requests for videos on color matching, and I just thought I'd show you different techniques I use whenever I use them. So I need to match this blue color right now, and there's a couple, two parts to making, redecorating this where I have to paint in a missing area. Now, we've got a bit of a fuzzy decoration here. So this has been painted with a paintbrush, and then it was fired. And then there was a clear glaze put over that. And all of that ended up in the paint. It's not paint, it's glaze. And it, as it melted, it diffused into those other glazes. And so it has a bit of a soft edge to it. So I'm probably going to have to do a combination of airbrush and a painting and then airbrushing to make this work. But first of all, I have to match the color. So in order to do that, I'm going to use this brand paint, Golden's acrylic. This is what I use on almost everything. And in this case, to make this color, I'm using these two colors. This is Payne's Gray. It's a blue with black in it. And the Golden's is the only people I know who make this color. They made it by mistake, and it was very popular, so they still make it. It's called Titan Buff. I use it quite a bit. So I put my Payne's Gray in here, and a couple drops of the Titan Buff, and I have something that looks like the color I need. And here's my technique, one of my techniques for matching the color. So what I do is, I found an area where I don't need to do any painting, and I'm going to put my color, put a couple drops of it right here, right on the thing, and then I touch it with my fingernail, which kind of distributes it, spreads it out, so it's not a big thick lump. This will, two things, it makes it thinner and it dries faster. And so now I'll just hit that with an airbrush, with a hairbrush, hair dryer. And now that's dry. And the reason I do that is because acrylic paints are lighter when they're wet, and they darken as they dry. And as you can see, that's a pretty good match. Now, probably because I use this color a lot, and I've mixed this color like a million times, I got pretty darn close the first time off here. So I'm gonna go with that color. If I needed to adjust this, I would add either more blue to darken this or more Titan Buff to lighten it, and I would repeat the process until I got a match. But that's basically how it's done. There's no magic to it. There's no secret. It's just, if you can't mix match colors, you shouldn't be doing this kind of work. But if you can, that's just a process of elimination. You mix a color, put it next to the color you want to match, and dry it, and then adjust accordingly. Lighter, darker, different shade, and just keep doing that until you match it. I just happened to hit it right off. So I mixed the color and I got my match of my blue on this platter, and now I'm done with the back. I'm going to put cold glaze on it, but I need to do this same color on the front, and I don't want to sit around and have to mix this paint again. So I'm going to save this, and the way I do that is I'll just tear off a piece of cling wrap, cover it nice and tightly, and that'll easily last a couple of days if it has to. It just saves me the trouble of having to mix this again tomorrow. Let that dry and we'll build up some more until we get the density just right. Doing my darkest coat now. This is a semi-transparent layer. I just need to darken some of these up. And here is the finished platter.